Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Cat's Track. We post an interview with an amazing Canadian each weekday for your daily inspiration. Today, I would like to introduce you to my friend, Jameela Ghann. Jameela was born and raised in Calgary. She tells me that her loved ones are the absolute best. Her mom and sister live next door, and they have a schedule with cooking. Super creative. Jameela used to have to cook every day of the week. Now she cooks once per week, as every adult takes a day, and then they takes a day to cook, and then they order on Friday together. So nice. Besides her loved ones, Jameela is most passionate about helping other businesses be better and sell more online. She believes that economic freedom and independence for BIPOC and women is the only true way to have equality and good outcomes for people. And you will find her full bio attached. Jameela, thank you so much for joining us today.
Well, thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate being here.
Well, thank you. I know you're busy, so are you ready for the questions that we sent you?
I am definitely ready.
Awesome. So the first one is the biggest one for everyone, it seems, is the greatest challenge over the last few months. What has it been for you?
So actually, the greatest challenge for me, which has been, okay, so for COVID, COVID has actually been really good for our business. We're an online business. So one of the biggest challenges has been shifting and keeping up with the online demand. So creating like systems and processes and making sure that we are communicating with our customers, because at the beginning, so many orders were delayed. So like that was like our biggest challenge, dealing with the influx of orders and how to get them out. And then also dealing with the shipping challenges of Canada Post. So like, I mean, it's been like good. I guess a
awesome.
Good for us.
I'm really proud of you. There's very few businesses can say that right now. And for your biggest navigating the new reality and how to get more product out there. Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah. So like, I'm not complaining. Like obviously being inside, like really, really sucked and all that other kind of stuff. But like, I find that we've been spending most of our time like trying to figure out how to continue to scale online, which is like great.
Congratulations, Jameela. I'm very proud of you.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
And what are the three things that you'd like to share with the audience today?
So three things that I want to share is that I think that every challenge presents an opportunity. So like for COVID, we lost basically all of our wholesale because retailers were closed, but then also the challenge of having people stay inside and having to deal with a new business environment has enabled us to sell online, and like the margins are so much better online. So like something crappy will happen, but then there's always like an opportunity that can happen in every challenge. So that's the first thing. And then the second thing is that nothing lasts forever. So like I go to Buddhist temple and one of the tenets is impermanence, and like good times don't last forever and bad times don't last forever. So you just have to accept the present moment and live in the present moment and understand that not every quarter are you going to make amazing sales, and not every quarter are you going to lose all of your wholesale business. And like, even though things feel like they're crappy, they will always get better. And you should never just hold on to things and internalize and make them personal. It's just the way life is. So that's the second thing. And then the third thing is the importance of family and having a really good family and having your family as a rock. So COVID really solidified this for me. And I have an amazing family that helps with, I have two daughters, so they help with taking care of my kids. And it just makes life so much better when you have a solid family unit and you have people that you can talk to and rely on. And especially during COVID when you're stuck with them the whole day. So that's like the third thing. So always making sure that you are have a great relationship with your family, and that you are also a really good family member yourself, and that people feel like they can count on you so that you can count on them. So those are the three things.
I love that. And you know, interestingly, I think we should dive a little deeper on that. I think that my dad used to say, to have a friend, you have to be a friend.
Yeah.
I think that speaks to your comment about being a good family member, and that's how you'll build stronger relationships. I also think that biological family is one thing, but choosing family members and calling them family and treating them like family, where we feel like truly we've got one another's back. We've got a village around us. It doesn't have to be our immediate family, right?
No, it doesn't. Because I mean, a lot of people, their family doesn't live close by, right? I mean, I like my family's my next door neighbor, but sometimes you do have to build those relationships and you do have to build your own family. And as long as you both parties have the understanding that you guys are in it together, basically forever, then it's fine. I mean, it's like anything else. It's like choosing a partner, right? Or deciding to get married. As long as there's like the core understanding that you guys are going to be there together through thick and thin, then yeah, you can pick whoever you want to be part of your circle.
Aw, that's so nice. I love it. Oh, awesome. And do you have a good news or legacy story you'd like to share outside of the amazing news that you've now shared that your business is booming and I'm delighted?
Oh, thanks. Well, I would like to, like, the legacy that for me is I also spent a lot of time during COVID helping other female owned businesses like do better online. And I've done a lot of like free like consulting calls and stuff with other women. So like, I think the legacy that I personally want to leave is that, like I said, there's always a challenge in like, or there's always an opportunity in every challenge, but you should also find people who are going to help you. And I'm happy that I've been able to help a lot of other women-owned businesses, specifically product-based businesses, do better and take advantage of the situation, because it's like fine for me to like make a lot of sales, but like if I'm not helping other people do better, then for me anyway, it's like not really that fulfilling to like make a lot of money. It's more fulfilling to help other people make money, because like we can all win. Like there's just so much to go around that I feel like we can all win. So that's like what I want my legacy to be able to help other people like do better, make money.
And you're already doing that. And have you ever read the book series called Go Givers?
I have not, but I've heard of it. I haven't read it.
You are that person.
Okay.
It's all about starting with the why you're doing it and where you're going to plan to serve, and mm-hmm. the money will come. And it really is. I mean, that's been your intention from the beginning, and and you're that. So if you read the book, just go, oh yeah, Catherine's right. That's me.
Okay, I'm writing it down right now.
Yeah, it's Go Givers, Go Givers Sell More, and Go Givers Leaders, and it's by an author named Bob Berg. You're going to love it, Jameela. It's all you.
Thank you. I'm taking a vacation at the end of this month, so I will, hopefully if the book comes soon enough, I'll be able to read it.
That's awesome. Well, I hope you enjoy. I wish you all the best and continued success. You deserve it.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Jameela. Everybody, that was Jameela Ghann. Wow, what a firecracker. Oh, amazing. I'm so delighted that she was able to join us, and I'm so delighted that you were able to join us today. Thanks for joining us on Cat's Track, and we'll see you next time.